think you're going? They call money to go out. You don't nothing. Who money are you spending? Y'all gonna have a red today. Sit down and be still. I'm not going with that. Come in here while me play mad. It's entertaining. Turn the air conditioner on. Quit turning my air off.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is bouncing.
I play the Raiders again. How do you do that, EA?
Looking to make an impact.
Let's put you in a cipher. Whoever you play, you're
going up against the Raiders. With that, we'll get you out to Oakland. So we'll hand it over to our colleagues, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, after an off-season of questions, football is back here in the East Bay at Oakland, California. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Oakland Raiders. Here on first down, throw it for his running back, and he's got him complete, and he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 11 on the gain there, and that'll be good for an Oakland first down. Quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Tackle is made by Clinton McDonald. Well, sometimes we talk running backs, sometimes we talk wide receivers. Walford, the tight end in this unit, very important.
Clive Walford, a terrific player. Knows how to work the inside portions of the field, but also can surprise you and get deep.
Here we go.
Some space here, and getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
All right, here we go. Wide and eight. Wide and eight.
Here's Carr. Now they go screen. It's complete. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it in the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away. Throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else. Bucs running a pattern that should be open.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. Quick pass play there on the slant, Charles. Works out well for the offense.
The offense loves it. The defender hates it. Hard to get through the body of the receiver to get to the football trying to cover a slant.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. Following the interception, Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he's brought down after a good game. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in,
Mike Evans, he's going to go. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans. 64 yards, and the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Well, the offense lining up first and 10. One receiver to the left is Cooper. To throw, it's Carr. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. The starting 11 defensively for Tampa Bay.
Quan Alexander is one of the exciting linebackers in the league. His forte, speed.
Back to the air on second down. It's Carr. And incomplete. Latavius Murray, the intended receiver, out of the backfield. And it's third down. Yards to go on third.
All right, here we go.
Throwing his car on third down. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. It'll be a gain of 9. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
All right, here we go. All right, here we go.
Here we go on fourth down with Carr. It finds Crabtree for the completion. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. The hitch route works. It's something you see quite a bit on third, fourth down in these situations, so they got it to go for.
And what you're counting on is a couple of things. One, you want the guy catching that route to make people miss right away, almost like a punt returner. And two, you expect him to pick up some blocks once he gets to the second level, able to get downfield. And on that play, everything came together.
Stop made there by Gerald McCoy. Second quarter, Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Here we go, ready.
Hey! Good cover. That's fake, man.
Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way.
Where did he go? Man, fumble the football. It's on the ground. My man won't even get it. His receiver's going to come back and dive on. Oh, man. That ain't funny. Look at me.
On first and 10, here's Carr. Finds Roberts left side. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. 3 yards to go here on second down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run.
Back over there. You ain't gonna hit it. You're gonna come off the tackle and ain't gonna hit it.
26 yard line. It's a gain of 4 there and it gives him a new set of downs.
I said the block is still gonna hit the guy.
The more first downs you pick up, better shape you'll be in as an offense.
They'll buy some time right. Brought in by Walford.
Oh, you out? They got the Raiders overrated, bro.
Brandon, I love how in the game of football,
that you got throwing people off and crap.
Research it, we find out it's old. Mobile quarterbacks have been around forever. Those who can extend a play and find open receivers downfield, those guys never get old.
All right,
here we go.
Run there, run there.
On second down, here's Carr. Can't find it. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
I'm trying to pick the ball off. You know that. They can make me lag all they want, so that means you lagging too.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Get over there.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Good pick.
David. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out.
We're gonna run
the line. Come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
How many yards we get?
Officially no gain on the play.
No gain.
Second down. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do?
Come on, fellas. We need to break a big run right
here. Slow up his feet and allow the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
On second down, Martin. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Give him 3 yards
third
on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. Second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. On third down, Winston.
Give me a good deep throw.
Big play downfield. He's got it.
Touchdown.
The 20, 10. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Josh Huff taking it in. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. And that drive happened quickly, which is great because they scored the points, but then their defense has to come right back out on the field.
It is exciting, isn't it, for the offense to do that? The defense is saying, okay, that's cool, but let's not make it a habit. We need to get some rest sometime.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw 2 interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
No, not quite of that level and not of that age.
See him up there? I see him.
Let's see what he's trying to do. A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. We'll come back to Oakland after this.
All right, here we go. Ready.
gets his man, Amari Cooper. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And now they're in the hurry up. On first down, Carr. Roberts with it over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming up the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from it, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Flushed out right, and this is caught. It's Cooper. The completion good for 3 and it's second down. One back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime.
Because finally, right before the half, they find a way to get the ball in the end zone and get some points on the board. Maybe they can use that to kickstart them for the second half.
Yeah, just to get something before going into the lockers. And now in the second half, they can just tighten.
It's what they want to do. Tighten down everything they're doing, and it maybe explode at the right time.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They come up in an offset eye. They start the drive with Martin, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. One receiver to the left is Evans. Play fake to Martin. Now Jameis. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
A dime look defensively for the Raiders on third down.
Yeah, you're right. 2 extra DBs out there. Jameis to throw it. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect, but as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. 16. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
So second and 10 here. Evans is alone to his right, and the wideout in motion. Now Jameis on second down. Drops it off to Martin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. Receiver to the left is Evans. Jackson, the man in motion left. Play clock winding down. Now a play fake here on first down. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
They'll send a receiver in motion left. First down, here's the run with Martin. And a solid run down inside the 30. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
In motion left, that's Jackson. Winston with a give to Martin. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know. And go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Jackson, the man in motion left. Winston gives to the tailback, Martin. And he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Well, that's the desired outcome coming out here in the second half of being able to run the football and establish a little bit of pace and maybe even a bit of dominance at the line of scrimmage. They want that to continue. Way too early to think about this being ball control time. But the way they're running it, you got to think they may want to continue that and see if they can go ahead and grind their opponents into submission.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
In motion left, that's Jackson. The play clock's running
is Martin.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22.
For those who watch the game and want to question the courage of the guys who play on the corner, how about when you see a toss sweep coming your way, yet you still go into the backfield, get past the blockers, and make the tackle? That's big league.
Is alone to his right. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Now a play fake to Martin. Here's Winston. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans, his second touchdown of the night. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this
one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. It's good, and it is now 21-7.
Y'all see how y'all missing that contour? Every time I make it up, I got up this morning and fixed it. Y'all finna stop sitting on it. I'm sick of y'all now. For real. I just fixed that thing this morning. Go in your room and play. Stop playing in here.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It's a gain of 24 that time. Good enough for an Oakland first down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Forced out to his left. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. In a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic, this is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him ever giving up?
One receiver to the left is Cooper. Now Carr throwing on second down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Don't make me start yelling.
Intercepted, picked off by Brent Grimes, and they will find